Hello everyone, let's see how to create these 12 text effects in Premiere Pro. Number 1. Glow text effect. Start by selecting the type tool and adding your text. You can adjust the text using the essential graphics panel, just ensure the fill color is set to white. Next, head over to the effects panel and search for drop shadow. Apply it to your text layer, then navigate to the effect controls panel. Under Drop Shadow, set the shadow color to white, opacity to 50%, distance to 0, and softness to 10. Now, duplicate the drop shadow by selecting it and pressing Ctrl plus C and Ctrl plus V. For the top drop shadow, increase the softness to 50. Duplicate it again and increase the softness to 100. Keep duplicating and adjust the softness to 200, 400, and finally 1000. Once you've stacked several drop shadows, search for Tint in the Effects panel and apply it to the text layer, making sure it's positioned above all the drop shadows. This allows you to map the white to any color of your choice. Pick a color, click OK, and you'll see your text glowing with that new hue. Number 2. Cinematic trailer text effect. First, select the Type tool and type your title. Then, select the text by pressing Ctrl plus A. Go to the Essential Graphics panel and customize the font style, size, and other settings to your preference. Now, duplicate the text like this. Move the second text slightly downward and adjust it as desired. You can also change the font styles and settings again if needed. If you don't want the second text, you can skip this part. Now, go to the Effect Controls panel and position your text in the center of the screen. Move forward a few frames and add a scale keyframe under motion. Then, move the playhead to the beginning of the clip and increase the scale. Right-click on that keyframe and select Ease Out. For the second keyframe, right-click and choose Ease In. After that, click the scale drop-down and adjust the keyframes like this. Next, select the pen tool under opacity and draw a box on the preview window like this. Adjust the feather to your liking and click the mask path stopwatch icon. Move the mask like this until the text disappears. Then move the playhead forward a few frames and adjust the mask again like this. And there you have it. You've created a cinematic trailer text animation. Number 3. Burning text effect. To get started in your project panel, create a new black video, drag it onto video track 3, and adjust its duration to your liking. We'll be using the lower video tracks later. With the black video layer selected, go to the effects panel and search for the circle effect. Double-click it to apply, then add the turbulent displace effect as well. Next, go to the Effect Controls panel and increase the circle effect's radius until the white area fully covers your text. Click the stopwatch icon next to the radius to set a keyframe. Move this keyframe to the end of the timeline, to the start, and set the radius value to 0. Now, let's adjust the turbulent displace settings. Increase the amount to around 300, set complexity to 10, and adjust evolution to 50. Now, add your text using the Type tool. In the Effect Controls panel, adjust the font and size to your preference. And use the alignment buttons to center the text. Now move this text layer to video track 2. With the text layer still selected, go to the Effects panel and add the Track Matte Key effect. Then, back in the Effect Controls panel, set the matte option to video track 3, since the black video is on track 3, and check the reverse option. To enhance the effect, hold the Alt key and drag the black video layer to an upper track to duplicate it. With a duplicated layer selected, go to the effects panel, add the Gaussian blur effect, and set the blurriness value to 100. Now, select the text layer, copy the existing track matte key effect, and paste it using Ctrl plus V. Set the matte to Video Track 4 to soften the edges. Next, duplicate the black video layer 2 more times and apply the invert effect to the top layer. In the Effect Controls panel, decrease the scale value to 96 to control the outline thickness of the wave effect. Select both these layers and nest them. Now, duplicate the bottom text layer. With the duplicated text layer selected, go to the Effect Controls panel. Change its fill color to orange. And delete the extra track matte key effect. Set the matte to Video Track 5, since the nested layer is on Track 5. Change the Composite Using option to Matte Luma and uncheck the Reverse option. This will create a burn effect. Number 4. Text behind the object. First, select the Type tool and type your text. Then, go to Essential Graphics to adjust the font, size, and color as you like. Position the text where you want it to appear on the screen. Next, select the text layer and zoom in on the preview screen. This will help you draw the path more accurately. Lower the opacity of the text layer so that the background is easier to see. Now, select the pen tool under opacity and draw around the object you want to appear in front of the text. After that, invert the mask by checking the inverted option. Click the stopwatch icon next to mask path. Then move a few frames forward and adjust the mask as the object moves. Repeat this process until the end of the clip. Once done, return the text layer opacity to 100%. And that's it, we're done. Number 5. Write on text effect. As a first step, select the Type tool and type in your text. Then head over to the Essential Graphics tab to make any adjustments you like. Once you're done with the changes, extend the duration of the text layer to about 5 seconds. Next, go to your project panel and create a transparent video layer. Place it above your text layer on the timeline. In the Effects panel, search for Write On and add it to the transparent video layer. Now, go to Effect Controls and change the color to red. Adjust the brush size so it's slightly larger than the text you're tracing. Set the stroke length to 5 seconds and brush spacing to 0.01 with the playhead at the start of the transparent layer. Click the stopwatch icon next to brush position. Click on Write On, then go to your preview screen and drag the red dot to your starting point. Move forward one frame using the right arrow key and drag the red dot to the next position in your trace. Continue doing this frame by frame until you've traced your entire word on the preview screen. Finally, go to Effect, find Track Matte Key, and drag it onto your text layer. In Effect Controls, set the matte to the video layer where you placed the transparent video. And that's it! Number 6. Fade In and Out Text Effect. Begin by selecting the Type tool and adding text. Then select the text and adjust it to your liking via the Essential Graphics panel. Next, open the Effects window and search for Linear Wipe. Add the Linear Wipe effect to the text layer twice. In the Effect Controls panel, under the first Linear Wipe effect, set the wipe angle to minus 90 degrees and the feather to 750. Make sure you are at the beginning of the text layer and create a keyframe for transition completion, setting the value to 100%. Move about 3 seconds forward and set the transition completion to 0. Now, while still at this point, go to the second linear wipe effect and set the feather to 750 as well. Create a keyframe for transition completion at 0. Then move another 3 seconds forward. Set the transition completion to 100% at this point, and you'll have text that smoothly fades in from left to right, and, after a few seconds, fades out. Number 7. Slice text effect. First, select the Type tool and type your text. Select all the text, change the font style and align it in the Essential Graphics panel. Next, go to the Effect Controls panel, select the Pen tool, and draw a mask like this. Set the mask feather to zero. Now, duplicate your text layer by holding the Alt key and dragging the layer upward like this. Select the first text layer, go to Effect Controls, and invert the mask. Move the playhead forward a few seconds and create a keyframe for position under motion. Then, select the second text layer and create a keyframe as well. Move forward a few more frames and change the position values like this. For the first text layer, adjust the position values as well. Right-click on the second text layer, select Nest, and click OK. Now, go to Effects, search for Drop Shadow, and drag it onto the nested layer. Select the nested layer. Go to Effect Controls, and under Drop Shadow, set the opacity to 100, the direction to 150, the distance to 25, and the softness to 20. Next, copy the Drop Shadow effect by pressing Ctrl plus C, then paste it with Ctrl plus V. Adjust the second Drop Shadow values. Set the distance to 50 and the softness to 120. Now, select the first text layer and move the playhead to the first keyframe. Select the nested layer. Create keyframes for both opacity settings under Drop Shadows and set the values to 0. Finally, move the playhead to the second keyframe. Select the nested layer again and change both opacity values to 100. And that's it, we're done. Number 8, Stretch Popup Text Effect. Begin by selecting the Type tool and adding text. Adjust it to your liking using the Essential Graphics panel. Next, open the Effects window, search for Transform, and add it to the text layer. Make sure the time indicator is at the start of the text layer. Then go to the Effect Controls panel. Under Transform, uncheck Uniform Scale. Create a keyframe for Scale Width and set its value to 1. Move 3 frames forward and change the scale width to 125. Then move another 3 frames forward and reset the scale width to 100. Uncheck Use Composition's Shutter Angle and increase the shutter angle to 360 to add motion blur to the text. Now you have the Stretch Popup effect. To apply this effect to another text layer, select the original text layer with the transform effect applied. Click on Transform in the Effect Controls and press Ctrl plus C to copy. Then, select a different text layer and press Ctrl plus V to paste. The effect will be applied to the new text layer. Number 9. Glitch Text Effect. I've already added a text layer to the timeline. First, head over to the Effects panel and search for VR Chromatic Aberrations. Drag and drop this effect onto the text layer. Next, go to the Effect Controls panel and adjust the settings. Change Aberration Red to 10, Aberration Blue to 0, and Fall Off Distance to 100. And that's it, we're done. Number 10, Reveal Text Effect. Begin by selecting the Type tool and adding your text. Select Fonts and adjust the font styles in Essential Graphics panel. Then open the Effects window. Search for Transform and add it to the text layer. Then search for Crop and add that to the text layer as well. In the Effect Controls panel, ensure that Crop appears first in the list. Click on Crop to select it, and in the preview window, drag the bottom crop indicator close to the text. Next, go to the Transform effect and create a keyframe for position. By clicking the stopwatch icon at the beginning of the layer, increase the second position value to move the text downward until it's no longer visible. Move 1 second forward and click the reset icon to return the text to its original position. Now, select both keyframes, right-click on any keyframe, and choose Ease In. Then, right-click again and select Ease Out. Expand the position property to reveal the graph editor. Drag the second blue handle all the way to the left to adjust the graph. Finally, uncheck Composition Shutter Angle and set the shutter angle to 360. This gives us a smooth text reveal animation. Now, let's create the text go back animation. After a few frames, create a new position keyframe. Move playhead 1 second forward and select first keyframe and drag it here holding Alt key. Once again, expand the position property and select the final keyframe. Drag this blue handle all the way to the right to adjust the graph. And there you have it. Number 11. Scrolling text animation. Begin by selecting the type tool and adding the first year where the animation will begin. Press Enter to move to the next line. Add the following year and keep doing this until you reach the final year where the animation will end. Next, select all the text by pressing Ctrl plus A. Go to the Essential Graphics panel to change the font size, font color, and other styles as you wish. Make sure to align the text to the center, then select the Type tool. Now, go over to the Effect Controls panel. Under Vector Motion, increase the second position value to scroll the text down to the starting position. Then, select the Rectangle Mask tool under the Opacity section and adjust the mask accordingly. Add a bit of feather to the mask. If you need to reposition the text again, you can do so via the position settings of the text. Next, go to the Effects panel, search for Directional Blur, and drag and drop it onto the text layer. Create a position keyframe and a blur length keyframe at the beginning of the video. Move a few seconds forward and adjust the position value to move the text down to the final year. Click on the mask again and adjust the position to ensure the text remains centered. Create another blur length keyframe at this point. Then, move to the middle of the animation and change the blur length value to 30. Now, select the position keyframes, right-click on any of them, and choose Temporal Interpolation Ease In. Then, right-click again and choose Ease Out. Expand the arrow next to position and drag the second blue handle slightly to the left to slow down the animation at the end. And there you have it, a smooth scrolling text animation. Number 12. Zoom Through Text Effect. First, select the Type tool and type your text. Then, adjust the font, font style, and text alignment to your liking in the Essential Graphics panel. Next, choose the Selection tool and double-click on the preview window. Move the small dot to the position where you want to zoom in. Go to Effect Controls and expand Vector Motion. Create a Scale keyframe at the beginning of the clip. Then, move a few seconds forward and increase the scale value until the screen is completely white. Now, our text animation is done. Let's smooth it out a bit. Select both keyframes, right-click any keyframe, and choose Ease Out. Then choose Ease In. Expand the Scale section and adjust the graph like this. Now, move your text to the second video layer and import your video to the first video layer. Select the video, go to Effects, search for Track Matte Key, and double-click to apply it. Finally, go to Effect Controls and, under Track Matte Key, set the matte to Video Layer 2. And that's it, we're done. If you have any questions, comment below, and I will reply as soon as possible. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. See you again in the next video.